Good morning, friend. Today I am going to take poem from 11th standard, Childhood. This poem is written by Markus Natten, and this poem is about the losing of the childhood. And poet raises several questions in this poem. The poet discusses the loss of his childhood, first of all. Then he talks about the very moment where his innocence was lost. Further, he talks about various incidents when he could have lost his childhood. Further, the realization comes to poet that world is not what it seems. He recalls when a change in his thought took place. The poet believes that people around him are hypocrites, full of hypocrisy. It seems that poet will never be able to trust the people around him ever again. This is because he is aware of their hypocrisy. The poet believes again that they preach love, but their actions don't reflect that. The poet tells us that his childhood went to some forgotten place. Moreover, the poet explains his childhood is hidden in a face of infant who is an innocent face. So now let us come to the, my dear friend, to childhood summary. First of all, the poet thinks and wonders about the end of his childhood, the loss of his childhood. He thinks where his childhood came to end. He wonders that it was the day on which he was no longer 11 years of age. Another option could be the time when author came to realization that hell and heaven didn't exist and no one could find them in a geography. This was the time when author could make a difference between the reality and fantasy. Poet comes to realization that they are imaginary places that have no existence in this real world. And these hell and heaven are in only in mind. Once again, the poet repeats the same question about the losing of his childhood. Now the poet wonders that was it the time when he began to view the world with a different perception? Naturally, when man grows older, or a human being grow older, their perception of the world changes automatically. We know. However, the poet seems to be deeply affected by this. Further, the poet came to realization that adults are hypocrites. This is because adults are not what they appear or seem to be. According to poet, adults preach about love, but their behavior is not so loving. So poet believes that double-faced nature is displayed by the adults or elders. So he asks, was this time when his childhood go? Again, he moving on, poet deliberates on same question regarding his loss of childhood. Further, the poet asks himself about various possibilities. Poet thinks about the day when he came to realization that his mind is own. This was the time when the poet came to realization that he can use his mind is in any way he wants. Poet also realized that his thoughts were his own. No one can affect them. One can see what? The poet became aware that he can produce his own thought. He had a free will. This was the time when the poet became of his own individuality and personality. Was that day the poet became lost of his childhood. In the last stanza, the poet became regret about his lost childhood. It seems the poet has desire to live his childhood once more. That is why he concludes that his childhood had vanished, had disappeared into forgotten place from which it can never return. Poet cherishes his lost innocence now. This is the type of innocence that one can only see in a baby's face, infant. He has only sweet childhood memories and which would fade away quickly. According to poet, innocence of childhood remains only until one is infant. Right? So this is the childhood poem, and conclusion of the poem is that how innocence of childhood get lost as when we grow up, grow older and become aware of the reality of life. As soon as we grow up and growing up, at a time our innocence, our childhood is going down. That is the conclusion. तो आइए दोस्तों कि जो चाइल्डहुड पोएम है मार्कस नैटन ने लिखी है और अपने बचपन के बारे में बता रहे हैं और आश्चर्य होता है उन्हें कि उनका बचपन कहाँ समाप्त हो गया. वो सोचता है कि वो दिन था जब वो 11 साल के नहीं थे और जब उनको एहसास हुआ कि नर्क और स्वर्ग मौजूद नहीं है, ना वो कोई किताब में नहीं है, ना वो कोई वास्तविक नहीं है लेकिन एक कल्पना है. उन्हें एक एहसास होता है कि काल्पनिक जगह भी इस दुनिया में अस्तित्व में नहीं है, वो खाली माइंड में है, मन में है. यहाँ पर बचपन के खोने के बारे में वो सवाल दोहराते हैं. कवि को आश्चर्य करता है कि यह वो समय था जब वो दुनिया को अलग धारणा के साथ देखना शुरू किया. स्वाभाविक रूप से जब मनुष्य बड़े होते हैं तो दुनिया के बारे में अपनी धारणा या उनकी धारणा कहीं ना कहीं बदल जाती है दोस्तों. हालांकि कवि इस गहरे सोच को वापस दोहराते हैं और वो कहते हैं कि वयस्क कि उनको दोबारा ऐसा लगता है कि लोग डबल फेस क्यों है. जहां पर बुजुर्ग लोग प्रेम की बातें करते हैं लेकिन उनका व्यवहार प्रेम जैसा नहीं होता है, उनका यहाँ पर डबल फेस दिखाई देता है. क्या ये वह समय था जब उनका बचपन गया? कवि का कहना है दोबारा अपने बचपन के नुकसान के बारे में सवाल पर विचार विमर्श कर रहे हैं. इसके अलावा पोएम विभिन्न संभावनाओं के बारे में भी खुद से पूछता है. वो पूछते हैं कि उस दिन के बारे में सोचते कि जब उन्हें एहसास होता है कि उनका दिमाग उनका था, उस समय वो अपने दिमाग इस्तेमाल कर सकते थे. जब उनको पता चला कि उनके विचार अपने थे, उसे कोई प्रभावित नहीं कर सकता था, तो ये वो समय था. तो यहां पर कहीं ना कहीं अपनी बचपन की सोच को दोहरा रहे हैं. तो वही सवाल खड़ा करते कि वह दिन था जहां उनका बचपन खो गया था, जब उन्हें पता चला कि उनके विचार और मन उनके थे. अंतिम पंक्तियों में दोस्तों कवि अपने खोए हुए बचपन के बारे में पश्चाताप करते हैं. कवि को अपना बचपन एक बार फिर से जीने की इच्छा है. वह निष्कर्ष निकालते हैं कि उनका बचपन एक विस्मृत जगह पर लुप्त हो गया है, एक ऐसे जगह पे खो गया है कि वहां से वो वापस नहीं आएगा. कवि अपनी खोई मासूमियत को संजोता है. यह एक प्रकार की मासूमियत है कि जिसको केवल एक बच्चे के चेहरे पर देखा जा सकता है दोस्तों. राइट? यह बच्चे के हंसी में छुपा है बचपन, राइट? तो यहां पर उनको लगता है कि जो उनका बचपन है वो बच्चे के चेहरे पर है, उसकी हंसी में है, राइट? सो निष्कर्ष यही है। सवाल यहां पर बहुत सारे दोस्तों वो कहते हैं कि मेरा बचपन कहां गया, बुजुर्ग क्यों ऐसे डबल स्टैंडर्ड रख रहे हैं, लोग क्यों कहते हैं कि स्वर्ग और नर्क है, लेकिन वो वास्तव में नहीं है। तो कहीं ना कहीं अपने बचपन की मासूमियत कैसे खो जाती है जब वो बड़े हो जाते हैं और जीवन की वास्तविकता से अवगत हो जाती है, ये निष्कर्ष निकल कर आ रहा है दोस्तों। तो पोएम को पढ़िए और देखिए कि आपको भी कहीं ना कहीं सवाल खड़े करेगा आपके बचपन के बारे में, कि आपका बचपन कहाँ खो गया है, राइट? और कहाँ चला गया है। थैंक यू।